I am Professor N.K. Chadha, former professor at Head Psychology Department, University of Delhi, and currently as Chief Bureau of Psychology, Chanakya IES Academy. Dear listener, in my earlier video, I have talked about emotional intelligence, understanding it from different perspective and its importance in one's life. In this video, I will be talking about how you can develop your emotional intelligence. First of all, it's very important for us to learn why emotional intelligence is required. I'm going to share with you 10 very, very important, significant areas for which it is emotional intelligence which is the answer. Number one, when you have not achieved all you expected, you would. Number two, when pressure seems to be ever present and increasing on you, to handle it, you require emotional intelligence. Number three, when you know you can do better, but you don't know how to do it. You are convinced you can do much better. You have the ability and capacity, but you don't know how to do it. Number four, when you feel that your boss does not understand you, or your parents don't understand you, your teacher don't understand you, your coach don't understand you, you require emotional intelligence to handle it. Next, when subordinates do not seem to be working as per your requirement and lack initiativeness, you require emotional intelligence to handle it. When your income is not that high as compared to the other people, you think, you find other people's income is too high and your income is not very high to handle that kind of situation, you require again emotional intelligence. Next, when you are not promoted with readiness and speed, which you deserve, you think that, you feel that, you should have given promotion earlier with readiness and fast, but you are not getting it. When you have new responsibilities that stretch you beyond your limits, new assignment, new projects, new responsibilities at workplace and family place, work-life balance, to handle that, you require emotional intelligence. And when your performance has dropped in the recent past, you find your performance had dropped. When you compare with the last month, before that, or last year, you find your performance not up to that. Or the organization you are heading, say for example, heading an organization, your organization not performing that fast. The progress had dropped, you handle through the emotional intelligence. Or when you feel little out of the place in this world, you feel your world is not meant for you, you feel lost in this world, to handle this situation also, you require say emotional intelligence. I hope my points are very clear to you. Now I am going to discuss with you the characteristics of high EQ person. Can you see a person, can you, not only person, can you think about yours? If you have these characteristics, it's a sign of high emotional intelligence. Who is that person? A person who knew a time to be aggressive, a time to be passive. Who can differentiate when to be aggressive, when to be keep quiet. That comes through the high emotional intelligence, can person can handle it. A time to be together and a time to be alone. A time to fight, a time to love. Who can differentiate when to fight, when to love. A time to cry, a time to laugh. A time to confront, a time to withdraw. A time to speak and a time to be silent. And lastly, a time to hurry, a time to wait for the right opportunity. To handling these situations, one requires a high amount of emotional intelligence. What are the characteristics of low emotional intelligent person? These are the person who make often complain, who talk often like, if I only I had a different job than the job which I am doing. What job I am doing, if I could have different job, that's a sign of a low emotional intelligence. If only I had completed my higher education from top international university. If only I had been handsome and beautiful. Means criticizes his own body. He says, I'm not handsome, you know. That's a sign of low emotional intelligence. If only my spouse had stopped drinking or smoking. If only I had been born rich and silver spoon in my mouth. If only I had better parents. And lastly, if only I had been married to someone else. The person who make these kind of complaints very often, if you make, that shows a sign of emotional intelligence. Once you understand the qualities or characteristics of high intelligent and low intelligent, now the question comes, can I develop my emotional intelligence? It's a big question, of $1 million question. And my answer to this is, yes, you can. You can develop your emotional intelligence. How? I'm going to give you few tips which will help you. If you follow them strictly, will help you in managing your emotional intelligence. These are, number one, observe how you react to people. See yourself, observe it. How you react to people? Do you rush to judgment before you know all of the facts? Is it like this? Do you stereotype kind of person who make judgments about people? A stereotype about some people? Or look honestly at how you think and interact with other people. See very honest, be honest, how you interact and think with other people. Try to put yourself in their perspective. Then I'm sure it will help you to observe your behavior of reacting to other people. Number two, look at your work environment, your surrounding. That is number one. In that, do you seek attention for your accomplishment? Is it that you try to seek attention for your accomplishment? Whatever you do, you want a recognition, accomplishment, or that accomplishment? Or humility can be a wonderful quality. Humility can be a wonderful quality. And it does not mean that you are shy or lack of self-determination. You see, not that. Or give others a chance to shine and put the focus on them. And don't worry too much about getting praise for yourself. It will come, I assure you. That is my second point. Look at your environment. The third point to raise your emotional intelligence, develop your emotional intelligence is that do a self-evaluation, which many of us lacks. We feel challenged. We feel afraid to do the self-evaluation, but which is very important. That is, what are your weaknesses? Why to run away from the weaknesses? Let me know my weaknesses. Let me diagnose it. Then I will see what I can do for that. Are you willing to accept that you are not perfect and that you could work on some areas to make yourself a better person? Are you willing for that? You are not perfect. There is some area where you are ready to work. Think over it. Thinking and having a feeling of, yes, you are prepared. Once you prepare yourself, we are going to help you erasing your emotional intelligence to a large extent. Have the courage to look into yourself with honesty. Have that courage. The moment you start, have the courage to look inside you with honesty, I'm sure that this will be a great step in enhancing your emotional intelligence. Fourth issue, examine how you react to stressful situation. Whenever this stressful situation comes in your life, how you react to that? Examine it. You are the best judge. Nobody else can. You know what's going inside you. I can standing outside, observe it from outside. But actually things are happening inside you. So examine that. That is, do you become upset every time there is a delay or something does not happen the way you want it should happen? Is it like this? You become restless. Things are not happening your way. Or do you blame others or become angry at them? Even when it is not their fault, maybe your youngster, maybe your subordinates, maybe your colleagues, you get angry. So things are not happening the way you want they should happen. Or keep yourself emotions under control when things go wrong. Putting all your efforts, but things can go wrong. Keep your emotion intact. Don't get emotion disturbed if things are not going or things are going the wrong way. Fifth point. Take responsibility for your actions. You have taken the action. You own the responsibility for your actions. Don't put the responsibility on someone else. That is, if you hurt someone's feeling, apologize directly. Don't ignore what you did. Avoid the person. Most of us avoid the person. Most of us are not ready to accept that you have done something wrong. If you have done something wrong, even by this person who is junior than you, maybe person who is less than age than yours, go directly, apologize. This will help you to take responsibility. People are normally more willing to forgive and forget. Largely, you will find people are, looks they will not forget and forgive you. Largely, people are there. So, if you make an honest attempt, I am sure you will agree with me. People will forget and forgive you. And that will help you in taking your responsibility, which is a very important component of raising your, developing your emotional intelligence. Lastly, sixth point, examine how your action will affect others before you take action. Once you are taking action, you have taken it. You can't do it. But my issue is that before taking action, think about how your actions are going to affect the other people, how these actions are going to affect your relationship. Because one of the very important issues of the emotional intelligence is relationship management with others, which I've discussed in my earlier video. So here you have to maintain relationship and examine that actions, how it's going to affect other people. If your actions or decision will impact other people's, put yourself in their place and feel it. If you are in that place, how you will feel it? Feel from that angle. Would you like to have that experience? Are you ready? That's a good sign. You are ready to take the experience. I'm sure that's a great sign in you that you want to examine your actions. If you must take actions, how can you help others through your actions? Once you have taken action, your intention was good, but somehow you have taken action. Once you take an action, still it can come back. See from the other perspective. Go to those people, approach to those people where you have taken action and see how it hurts them. And again, go and apologize with honesty. Not for the sake of apology you are going it. Determine, are you prepared to go for that? By apologizing, you are not going to become a small person. Your position will, in fact, wherever you stand, it will go further high. I'm sure the six area which I've discussed with you, my dear listener, you must have heard it very carefully. And I'm hopeful, I pray and wish that you take action. And these actions will help you. As I said earlier also in my earlier video, again I'm repeating the point that the contribution of emotional intelligence in one success is 4 times than the IQ. If you want to really go up the ladder, you want to be promoted by readiness and speed, what you deserve, you need to develop your emotional intelligence. And this emotional intelligence is a very important thing, as many of young students are preparing for the competitive examination, UPSC, other kind of examination. This will help you controlling your subject matter, your coursework, and time management in perspective, and help you in achieving your goal with a success in life, so that you become happy, your parents become happy, nation also got become happy with that. Thanks and good luck.
Subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to get latest updates on upcoming videos.